Hello, welcome to Garden Chronicles. My name is James David, and in today's video, I would like to talk about this particular type of carnivorous plant, commonly known as pitcher plants. Here, if you ever notice that this particular one seems to have a lot of pictures for a singular plant, and I might say that this particular red type are the latest hybrid that has been cultivated for this particular season. Based on my experience, I must say that this particular type of pitcher plants are often introduced more on a yearly affair, in a point of view to say that these hybrids are sort of cultivated and introduced in the market to create that kind of hype where these are new plants that are not available as more of the earlier versions where they have been introduced time to time. Due to this particular factor, because of these new hybrids that's been introduced, especially for this particular time, I must say that for this factor, these plant prices are sold in premium prices. Here in this section, I would like to share simple basic care tips for this pitcher plant. Number one, never fertilize these pitcher plants as this might cause them to overgrow on their leaves and discounts on the pitcher growths. If you would like have noticed some of the older version or the one that have been kept aside in the corner of the nurseries or kept aside because of no sale, you will notice that the leaves might have grown longer and bigger and their pitchers have gone missing. This is the fact due to the fact that these have received too much nitrogen and the plant has ditched the pitchers. Tip number two is watering. I would always want to overemphasize on this is that watering is the utmost importance here, because in nature, they do not receive any fertilizer or any chemical-laced water. Hence, always use chlorine-free or if possible, use rainwater or filtered water, as these plants don't do so well with chemical-laced water. You will sometimes notice burns on pitchers or even the leaves turn a little bit of yellow and telltale signs where the wrong watering has been applied for these particular plants. Tip number three, feeding. I know there's a lot of people who always emphasize on feeding meat or even put fish food or even osmocod in funny stuff that they've been experimenting. And the problem here is that overfeeding can actually cause these pitchers to burn or even dry out and even sometimes kill the plant. So go easy on feeding. If possible, let nature take its course. However, you can actually observe that if the pitcher have actually dried out or accidentally the water has been poured out from the pitcher, you can actually pour 1/3 of rainwater into the container of the pitcher to keep that pitcher more on a moisture level so it won't dry out over time. As you can see over here, these are the three different types of pitcher plants that has been sold here in this local nursery here. And you can see the red version and more on the green version and also the long version. Basically, I can say that these are ones that is actually been sold here in batches. And I believe that these are very much more on a highland type. Hence, a lot of care is required in a way that acclimatization is required, because they can actually face a lot of burns if they are introduced in direct hot sun immediately. One of the factors that, this is sort of like a paradox is that the pitchers may not form if they do not receive good indirect bright light. Hence, this is one of the factors that is required. And another factor of the paradox is that they also need very high humidity in order to, for the pitchers to form. So it is sort of like going to be a little bit more on a challenge factor. Hence, because of this challenge, these particular plants are not easily maintained and cultivated in a common beginner kind of garden setup. One of the most challenging factor here is that these particular plants are tropical plants, and because it's tropical, they require constant level of climate stability. Sort of Noe says that they do not go dormant, unlike other types of carnivorous plants that do tend to go dormant, especially the Venus flytrap or even the Sarracenia, which grows more on the northern American side. Hence, these particular ones, these pitcher plants, are very much more towards the South Asia region, especially throughout Malaysia, Indonesia, and some part of Philippines. On the factor of medium, I must say that keeping the medium very much like sterile condition, in a way to say away from minerals and fertilizer, actually causes this particular plant to form pitchers as they are actually looking for food. I must say that food need to be very much ministered or administered through the pitcher rather from the roots, and this is actually very important, because if there are any minerals found or any fertilizer kind of NPK found along the medium, the pitchers may tend to become smaller and even disappear. Hence, it is very important to keep this particular plant hungry, in a way to say devoid of any minerals or food, and that this will actually cause the plant to produce bigger and healthy pitchers. I've now come to the end of my video. If you can support me by clicking like and subscribe, and even put a comment on too on your thoughts concerning pitcher plants, as this also will generate more interest and viewpoints in my video. Hope you enjoyed this particular video, and catch you again in my next one. Take care and have a nice day. Bye.